going on, everybody? Thank you so much for coming back to another video. And in today's video, we are talking about the second episode of Season 7 of The Clone Wars, A Distant Echo. So once again, this is your spoiler warning. This video will be filled with spoilers, and I will be speaking as if you have already seen this episode. So in this episode of the returning season of The Clone Wars, we are essentially following the story of the last episode. In the last episode, we are introduced to the Bad Batch, essentially a defective set of clones who have their own particular set of skills, and I really enjoy their characters. I enjoy the four of them. They're really cool. You have the smart guy, the leader, who's essentially got hunting skills, you got the brute of the group, and then you have the sharpshooter. I really enjoy them. The four of them are really cool, and I enjoy seeing them in the mix with Captain Rex. And in this episode, not only do you have Captain Rex, but you also have Anakin Skywalker, who is helping them and joining them on this mission to Skakel Minor to find the location of an old clone called Echo, who is believed to have been dead. In the last episodes, the clones discover that the Separatists have something, some sort of algorithm that is helping them to work against their tactics. They pretty much know their strategies, and when they do something one time, the next time it does not work out so well for them. And yeah, they're starting to realize they're learning, they know their strategies, and it seems almost too personal that they know them too well. And at the end of the last episode, they discover that via being a prisoner or helping them out, that Clone Troop Echo may very well be alive, and that he is actually working with the Separatists in some way, shape, or form for them to know their strategies, to know their tactics. So this episode follows Anakin Skywalker, Captain Rex, and the rest of the Bad Batch as they try to find if Echo is alive on Skakel Minor. And yeah, what I really loved about this episode, again, the animation is just so good. It's so great to be back in the Clone Wars and be able to see this animation that stays true to what the animation always was, but also is able to update it and give it a new, fresh vibe and keep it looking a little bit smoother. Some of the action is so crisp and clean. And that was one of my favorite things about this episode. Some of the coolest action we've seen in the series as overall. I really love what they're doing with the gunplay in this show. There's a lot of really great hand-to-hand combat in this show, and I really love seeing Anakin and be able to see like some of the first lightsaber action that we're getting to see in this season. I just really enjoyed all the characters together. One of my little favorite moments that happened near the beginning of the episode is there's a moment where Anakin needs to call Padme, and obviously Anakin is still keeping his relationship a secret. However, Captain Rex knows, and it's great. There's this great moment where he essentially just lets him go and make a quick hologram call to Padme while Captain Rex is essentially watching the door, and Obi-Wan shows up at one point, and it starts to get a little bit awkward. And there's a moment after that where Obi-Wan says to Anakin, after realizing that they're lying to him about what Anakin was doing in that room, he essentially tells Anakin, "I hope you said hi to Padme for me." And Anakin turns around and has this moment of like, oh shit, does he know? So I like that because it kind of hints that Obi-Wan has known for a lot longer than we may think. And yeah, I really enjoyed that sequence. It was a quick little scene, but I found it to be funny, and I really enjoyed that character moment. And then the rest of the episode is essentially just a really great action episode that sets us on the path to go and find Echo. And by the end of the episode, they do find Echo. He is alive. He's attached to some sort of machine that they have tubes in his head. His eyes are moving around all crazy, and it's clear that he is not in control of what they're doing to him, and they're essentially just ripping through his mind to try to find out all the strategies that the clones have in order for them to have the upper hand on the clone troops and the Republic. This isn't really an episode that has too many character building moments or character moments in general. I think the character who's going to have the biggest arc in this arc is probably going to be Captain Rex. You know, he's had to kind of deal with the idea of this old clone troop that he loved and was attached to is still alive, and now he's being used for negative things. And he even says it in the episode that in the past he's lost a lot of people. He's lost a lot of his brothers, a lot of clone troopers, and for the most part, he tries not to cling on to every single one of them, but there's just something about this one that just has him feeling so off, and he just is a little bit on edge. He's kind of getting in a little bit of a fight with the Bad Batch here and there, and he's quick to kind of anger, and you can tell that this whole situation is really bothering him. So I am really curious to see what Captain Rex's arc will be at the end of this little arc. I really do enjoy him and the camaraderie and just everybody together with the Bad Batch. I like the chemistry between all the characters, even if there's tension. And on an overall level, I'm really excited to see how this Bad Batch arc ends. I think they only have two more episodes in this arc, and then they're going to move on to the Ahsoka arc. So I'm super excited to see what they do with the rest of the season. I had a lot of fun watching this episode. Yeah, it's not an episode that there's too much to talk to, I think, story-wise, but the small character moment I mentioned earlier with Anakin, Rex, and when he's calling Padme, as well as the moments with Echo and just everything else, I really did enjoy the character moments. I enjoyed the action. I enjoyed the visuals. There's some really, really great visuals in this episode, and it just leaves me more and more excited for what the next episode will hold. Sometimes I just hate that the Clone Wars is only like 20-minute episodes, because I just feel like it ends and you're like, no, I want more, and there's only 12 episodes in the season, so I just really hope that the last half of this season and the rest of the season has an overhaul. We know we're only two episodes in. I just really hope that the next part of the season is just really deep with lore and story building, because I really, really want to see more of these characters and more time spent with them. And it just feels like we get great episodes. These last two episodes have been great, but then they just feel so short. And maybe it's just because I want more Clone Wars. But yeah, I'm loving this season so far. I really love this episode. I'm looking forward to the third episode in the Bad Batch arc. And yeah, let me know what you guys thought. Let me know if you liked this episode. Did you not like this episode? Leave those comments down below. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. And I will see each and every single one of you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.